Good blessed Wednesday morning, January the 20th, 2021. It's about 11:07 a.m. in the morning. I greet all human beings around the world with the universal greetings of peace and the blessings of God be with you. Doesn't matter what your political, philosophical, personal, nor religious beliefs may be. It doesn't matter whether you're the richest or the poorest person on the face of this earth. It doesn't even matter whether you are the proclaimed toughest to the proclaimed weakest person on the face of this earth. Doesn't matter if you family, friends, nor proclaimed enemies. It doesn't matter whether you like me, nor my YouTube channel, nor anything that I put on social internet. My YouTube channel is Raymond, R-A-Y-M-O-N-D-I-V-I-V-Y. I encourage everybody to watch it, whether you like me or not. I encourage you to watch it because it's free. It doesn't cost you nothing but your undivided attention. Today, Biden and Harrison was just sworn in as president and vice president. Harris has made history being the first female vice president and the first female black vice president or black. Vice president in the office. And they have made history. I see a lot of other people and that's your prerogative. I don't look down on you. Those are saying that we made history. I didn't make history. They made history. Just like when Obama and Michelle came in office and did two terms. They made history. I didn't make history. The reason why I say they made history because, they made history because they was the one that was elected to the office to serve all people. It doesn't matter whether they're a Democrat, Republican, Tea Party, or Independent. They was elected to serve all people. And I'm going to get to that in a minute. I am glad to get Donald Trump and his crew up out of there. You see what I'm saying? Because he did the same thing just like some of the other presidents, you know what I mean, before him did. You see, it don't make no difference what color they is, because this is what I want to say. When you say we made history, when Obama and Michelle became, Obama came the president of the United States, when you said made history because he was black, he made history, true enough. But if you lived in Charleston, Missouri, Mississippi County, like I do, you see what I'm saying? When Democrats is running it, racist whites and sellout black Democrats is running Mississippi County, Charleston, Missouri, which in Charleston, Missouri is 5,947 people. It's a message in this here. 5,947 people, give or take. It may be more than that now because that particular census was 2000, I believe, in 10, but they took one in 2020, and I don't know if the count came out, but I'm sure the blacks still outnumber the whites. But tell me how in a town like this, small as this, 5,947 people, 51% black, and 46% is white. Why is it only one black police on the force? One black, a black sergeant, who has really no ties as far as trying to uplift the black community. So I just say we don't have no blacks on there. He black in color, but he's not black in trying to help blacks. Why is it we have a sheriff department with no white sheriff deputies? Why do we have a courthouse with no black prosecutors, no black public defenders, no black judges? We have, about two blacks that work in the clerk's office. Why do we have a city hall that's 99.99% white? I'm going to tell you why. It's because when you voting for Democrat or Republican, you voting for the individual that's running. You see what I'm saying? And the people that's close to them is the only ones that's going to benefit. Some of y'all may say that that's not true. All you got to do is look. How many? I know people in Chicago that complaining about their alderman. And guess what color their alderman is? Skin color the same as mine. And it's not from a suntan from Florida. You see what I'm saying? They not doing, some of them not doing their job. You see what I'm saying? But one thing about it, God reveals him. Look how he revealed Jesse Jackson Jr., him and his wife. Then when he get caught up, all these years that he's stealing all that money, wearing all them expensive fur coats and all that old stuff that he done stole money from the black community, not the white community, the black community. You see what I'm saying? Then all of a sudden, he's bipolar. You see what I'm saying? He's bipolar all of a sudden. But see, if a white person did it, then it's a whole different thing. I don't care what color they is, I'm going to set them out. I'm taking this time out right now because everybody is celebrating and saying, we won. Let me tell you what we won in Africa. When Nelson Mandela was freed after 27 years being in the penitentiary, the Bible speaks about this. Look it up in Proverbs. When a slave become king. You see what I'm saying? Nelson Mandela, when he got out, see, you got the change. You notice he was married. He was dedicated to Wendy Mandela, but it was something that Wendy must have not been doing right when he got out. He married again. You see what I'm saying? God tell you, don't look back. It was something that Nelson seen, and Nelson wasn't a dumb man. Nelson stood up against one of the most racist countries in the world. It was almost like standing up against Adolf Hitler. But he did them 27 years. He could have got out sooner than that if he'd have broke down. But see, when he became president, he made sure that them folks that took, them white folks that took that land from them people, he got to working on that. You see what I'm saying? When you the president, you the president of all people. Harold Washington showed a good sign of an individual that ran for office and stood up. You see what I'm saying? President Obama, he came down to one of the most prejudiced cities here in the state of Missouri, Joplin, Missouri, where I believe it was 90, it's probably still 90-some percent white. Well, they didn't even like black peoples at the time. And I don't even know if they like it now. Don't even care. You see what I'm saying? But he went down there, but he couldn't come down to a town like this here. Well, blacks, I'm talking about non-sellout blacks, is being oppressed. You see, that's where Martin Luther King went. That's where Nelson Mandela went. That's what Malcolm X went. You see, Martin Luther King lost his life. For those of y'all talking about ain't no such thing as black on black crime and all. But Martin Luther King lost his life because he was concerned about the garbage workers not getting the proper pay and working up under unsanitary, unhumane conditions. He lost his life. You see what I'm saying? But how many of y'all really feel that we won? I'm glad to see them in there, hoping it's going to be a change. You see what I'm saying? I'm hoping my daddy can live to see a change here in his hometown. My daddy, 93 years plus. When his daddy moved from Arkansas and all of his brothers was born here, it was racism. It's still racism here. You see what I'm saying? Let me tell you, Obama and Michelle, nothing personal against them. They millionaires now. You see, if you look at the history, before he became senator, he was marching with them civil rights leaders in the city of Chicago, getting on them slum lords and all that there. But he's living in a 17 point, I believe, five or $2 million home in Martha's Vineyard in Massachusetts. You see, you don't see him coming to none of these protesters. He got the CIA with him. So he got the biggest security there. You don't see him coming and speaking out about all of this black on black killing, but you're going to see him anytime a Democrat running from something, they're going to support each other. You see what I'm saying? You know, it's not a Democrat or Republican thing, because there's Democrats that have been in office that did the same thing that Trump did in office. You see what I'm saying? When they give you a block of cheese, you're satisfied. You see what I'm saying? When they do something that favors you, your family and friends, you satisfied. But we got to wake up, y'all. Why they in office? Let's have Harris and Biden correct some of the things that they did. And those of y'all don't know, filling up the penitentiaries with blacks. You see what I'm saying? They got a chance to redeem themselves. You see what I'm saying? They got a chance to redeem themselves, but some of y'all don't even look at that. But I'm just going to say this here, and I'm going to leave. Those of y'all that still fighting against black-on-black crime, no matter what somebody said, whether it's your relative or not, keep your community safe. Those of y'all that's fighting against injustice, you know, you got some of these people because they got a little money or they got friends. You see what I'm saying? That says it's not no racism going on. Then they say it's no racism. I don't care how many white friends or any other friends I got. I don't care if they rich or poor. It's racism going on in this country, especially here in Charleston, Missouri, Mississippi County. And I know it's going on every place else. Congratulations, Biden and Harris. I hope y'all do something that these other presidents haven't done here in Charleston, Missouri, and that's include Obama. Not a doggone thing to help blacks that's suffering down here, that blacks is being mistreated in the courthouse, the police station, and everywhere else being mistreated by Democrats. Here it is, the chief of police, white, a Democrat until a black run, then he vote Republican. Now, you think about that. Got a big old Trump sign in his yard. But yet his family, his uncle, Warren E. Hearns, was a Democratic governor here. But when a black person run, they ain't going to vote for him. They don't want him in there. Y'all wake up. You know what I mean? Wake up. All Democrats ain't trying to help you. Some of them is worse than Adolf Hitler. Peace be still.